MCQ on Public International Law, Part 2 by Deepak, Miglani. We help the students in preparation of judicial services examination. If you want to receive regular updates, please send us your mobile number through WhatsApp on 8199898985. Question number 26. A limited procedural capacity, that is, power to enforce claims before an international tribunal, has been conferred upon the individuals under international law. It includes option A, right to petition the Human Rights Committee without the mediation of state in case of violation of any of their civil and political rights by the state of which they are national. Option B, right to petition the Human Rights Committee without the mediation of state in case of violation of any of their civil and political rights by the state of which they are national or not. Option C, locus standi in the proceedings before the International Court of Justice. Option D, none of the above. A limited procedural capacity, that is power to enforce claims before an international tribunal, has been conferred upon the individuals under international law. It includes right to petition the Human Rights Committee without the mediation of state in case of violation of any of their civil and political rights by the state of which they are national or not. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Question number 27. Who said that there is only one source of international law, viz. Common consent? Option A, Oppenheim. Option B, Stark. Option C, Grotius. Option D, Bentham. Oppenheim said that there is only one source of international law, viz. Common consent. Answer is option A. Question number 28. The main source of international law in Article 31, Sub-Article 1 of the Statute of ICJ is option A, International Convention and Customs. Option B, General Principles of Law Recognized by Civilized Nations. Option C, Judicial Decision and Teachings. Option D, all of the above. The main source of international law in Article 31, Sub-Article 1 of the Statute of ICJ is International Convention and Customs. Answer is option A. Question number 29. In Article 38, Sub-Article 2 of ICJ, the words ex aequo et bono mean option A, considerations of fair dealing and good faith. Option B, bona fide behavior by states. Option C, relationship of past does not bother present. Option D, none of the above. In Article 38, Sub-Article 2 of ICJ, the words ex aequo et bono mean considerations of fair dealing and good faith. Answer is option A. Question number 30. Article 38 is not exhaustive, but mere declaratory in nature. Option A, true. Option B, false. Option C, depends on ICJ. Option D, none of the above. Article 38 is not exhaustive, but merely declaratory in nature. True. Answer is option A. Question number 31. Which is the oldest and most original source of international law? Option A, international treaties and conventions. Option B, international customs. Option C, general principles of law recognized by civilized nations. Option D, all of the above. Which is the oldest and most original source of international law? International customs. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Question number 32. Custom and usage are option A, antonyms. Option B, synonyms. Option C, usage is first step towards custom. Option D, custom is first step towards usage. Custom and usage are usage is first step towards custom. Answer is option C. Question number 33. Usage represents the twilight stage of the customs. Customs begins where usage ends. Usage is an international habit that has yet not received full legal attestation. Said by option A, Oppenheim. Option B, Stark. Option C, Bradley. Option D, Holland. Usage represents the twilight stage of the customs. Custom begins where usage ends. Usage is an international habit that has yet not received full legal attestation, said by Stark. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Question number 34. A usage crystallized into a custom through option A, conducts of the states at the diplomatic level. Option B, foreign policy documents. Option C, practice of international organs like the UN and ICJ. Option D, all of the above. A usage crystallized into a custom through conducts of the state at the diplomatic level. A usage crystallized into a custom through foreign policy documents. A usage crystallized into a custom through practice of international organs like the UN and ICJ. Answer is option D. Option D is answer. Question number 35. The true test whether a usage has crystallized into a custom is that option A, it must be approved by the common consent of civilized nations or general consensus of opinions. Option B, it should be the evidence of general practice accepted as law. Option C, feeling on the part of states that acting as they do, they are fulfilling legal obligations, that is, opinio juris sine necessitatis. Answer is option D. Option D is answer. Question number 36. In which of the following cases it was held that a provision of a treaty may also generate a rule of customary international law? Option A, North Sea Continental Shelf case. Option B, the right of passage case. Option C, Aslim case. Option D, both A and B. In which of the following cases it was held that a provision of a treaty may also generate a rule of customary international law? North Sea Continental Shelf case, the rights of passage case. Answer is option D, both option A and B. Option D is answer. Question number 37. Custom includes the following features. Option A, consistency, continuity and uniformity. Option B, antiquity. Option C, efficacy and consistency. Option D, both A and B. Custom includes the following features: consistency, continuity and uniformity. Antiquity. Answer is option D, both A and B. Option D is answer. Question number 38. In which of the following cases it was held that the special or local or regional custom which derogates from general customary law becomes binding only on states that support it? Option A, S.S. Lotus case. Option B, the Aslim case. Option C, both A and B. Option D, North Sea Continental Shelf case. In which of the following cases it was held that the special or local or regional custom which derogates from general customary law becomes binding only on states that support it? The Aslim case. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Question number 39. Which case demonstrates that the opinio juris is essential to the creation of a new customary rule of international law? Option A, S.S. Lotus case. Option B, the Aslim case. Option C, North Continental Shelf case. Option D, none of the above. Which case demonstrates that the opinio juris is essential to the creation of a new customary rule of international law? S.S. Lotus case. Answer is option A. Option A is answer. Question number 40. In the modern period, international treaties or conventions are the most important source of international law. Which treaty may be the source of international law? Option A, law-making treaties. Option B, treaty contracts. Option C, both A and B. Option D, none of the above. In the modern period, international treaties or conventions are the most important source of international law. Which treaty may be the source of international law? Law-making treaties, treaty contracts. Both option A and B. Answer is option C. Option C is answer. Question number 41. International treaties are agreements of a contractual character between states or organization of states creating legal rights and duties. Who said that? Option A, Oppenheim. ऑप्शन बी हाल, ऑप्शन सी स्टार्क, ऑप्शन डी स्क्वाजेन बर्जर। इंटरनेशनल ट्रीटीज आर एग्रीमेंट्स ऑफ ए कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल करेक्टर बिटवीन स्टेट्स और ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ऑफ स्टेट्स क्रिएटिंग लीगल राइट्स एंड ड्यूटीज। हु सेड दैट? ओपनहेम। आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए। क्वेश्चन नंबर 42। हु सेड ट्रीटीज आर लीगली बाइंडिंग बिकॉज देयर एग्जिस्ट ए कस्टमरी रूल ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लॉ दैट ट्रीटीज आर बाइंडिंग। ऑप्शन ए ओपनहेम, ऑप्शन बी हाल, ऑप्शन सी स्टार्क, ऑप्शन डी लॉटर पैच। हु सेड ट्रीटीज आर लीगली बाइंडिंग बिकॉज देयर एग्जिस्ट ए कस्टमरी रूल ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लॉ दैट ट्रीटीज आर बाइंडिंग। लॉटर पैच। आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी। ऑप्शन डी इज आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 43। द बेसिस ऑफ द बाइंडिंग फोर्स ऑफ ट्रीटीज इज। ऑप्शन ए पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा, ऑप्शन बी रिबस सिक स्टेंटिबस, ऑप्शन सी एक्स एक्वो एट बोनो, ऑप्शन डी ओपिनियो जूरिस एट नेसेसिटेट्स। द बेसिस ऑफ द बाइंडिंग फोर्स ऑफ ट्रीटीज इज पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा। आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए। ऑप्शन ए इज आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 44। स्टेट्स आर बाउंड टू फुलफिल इन गुड फेथ द ऑब्लिगेशंस एज्यूम्ड बाय देम अंडर ट्रीटीज इट इंप्लाइज। ऑप्शन ए पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा, ऑप्शन बी रिबस सिक स्टेंटिबस, ऑप्शन सी एक्स एक्वो एट बोनो, ऑप्शन डी ओपिनियो जूरिस एट नेसेसिटेट्स। स्टेट्स आर बाउंड टू फुलफिल इन गुड फेथ द ऑब्लिगेशंस एज्यूम्ड बाय देम अंडर ट्रीटीज इट इंप्लाइज पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा। आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए। ऑप्शन ए इज आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 45। मार्क द इनकोरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। ऑप्शन ए एवरी ट्रीटी इन फोर्स इज बाइंडिंग अपॉन द पार्टीज टू इट एंड मस्ट बी परफॉर्म्ड बाय देम इन गुड फेथ। ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। ऑप्शन बी नो पार्टी टू ए ट्रीटी माइट अटेम्प्ट टू जस्टिफाई इट्स फेलियर टू परफॉर्म एनी ऑफ इट्स इंटरनेशनल ट्रीटी ऑब्लिगेशंस बाय इन्वोकेशन ऑफ इट्स इंटरनल लॉ। ऑप्शन बी इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। ऑप्शन डी पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा इज नॉट एन एब्सोल्यूट प्रिंसिपल फॉर इट फेल्स टू एक्सप्लेन द बाइंडिंग फोर्स ऑफ कस्टमरी रूल्स ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लॉ। ऑप्शन डी इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। ऑप्शन सी रेब्यूस सिक स्टेंटिबस इज नॉट एन एक्सेप्शन टू द रूल ऑफ पैक्टा सुंट सर्वांडा। ऑप्शन सी इज इनकोरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी। ऑप्शन सी इज आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 46। अकॉर्डिंग टू द वियना कन्वेंशन 1969 विच स्टेट इज कंपिटेंट टू मेक ए ट्रीटी। ऑप्शन ए सॉवरन स्टेट ओनली, ऑप्शन बी एवरी स्टेट, ऑप्शन सी एवरी स्टेट बट नॉट ए न्यूट्रलाइज्ड स्टेट, ऑप्शन डी एवरी मेंबर स्टेट ऑफ यूएन। अकॉर्डिंग टू द वियना कन्वेंशन 1969 विच स्टेट इज कंपिटेंट टू मेक ए ट्रीटी। एवरी स्टेट बट नॉट ए न्यूट्रलाइज्ड स्टेट। आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी। ऑप्शन सी इज आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 47। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट ए necessary step for the formation or conclusion of all treaties. Option A, accrediting of persons by the contracting states. Option B, negotiation and adoption. Option C, signature. Option D, ratification. Which of the following is not a necessary step for the formation or conclusion of all treaties? Ratification is not a necessary step for the formation or conclusion of all treaties. Option D is answer. Answer is option D. Question number 48. A method by which a state may, in certain circumstances, become a party to a treaty of which it is not a signatory is called. Option A, accession. Option B, ratification. Option C, negotiation. Option D, none of the above. A method by which a state may, in certain circumstances, become a party to a treaty of which it is not a signatory is called accession. Answer is option A. Option A is answer. Question number 49. An international act whereby a state establishes on the international plane its consent to be bound by a treaty is called. Option A, accession. Option B, ratification. Option C, negotiation. Option D, adhesion. An international act whereby a state establishes on the international plane its consent to be bound by a treaty is called ratification. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Question number 50. States are not bound by treaties unless it is. Option A, signed. Option B, ratified. Option C, agreed. Option D, none of the above. States are not bound by treaties unless it is ratified. Answer is option B. Option B is answer. Please like the video, share the video and subscribe the YouTube channel. Thank you.